Hello, malty, mushy, mashbill malt mates. And thank you to Stephen Pinder for that introductory malt mention to Ralfy Review 714. Welcome to the Manx Bothy. It may be damp, a little bit cold, but really, we keep ourselves cosy and warm with these whisky reviews. And I'm Ralfy, and I have poured 15 minutes ago a glass of this Scotch single malt whisky from an independent bottler called Cadenhead's, which is homed in Campbelltown and part of Springbank Distillery. Yep, thought you might like to know. Cadenhead's is also the oldest independent bottler of whisky in Scotland. There you go. Now you know. But I think you knew that. But I tell you what you didn't know is that I have never actually reviewed in 9 years at ralfy.com Tullibardine single malt whisky. Never. There are a number of single malts that I have yet to review for you, which you may have come across in your travels, and you might have been looking for a review in the ralfy.com archives, in the search, in the channel, and you haven't found it. But we're about to change that now with my first review of a Tullibardine single malt Scotch whisky. Here it is. Let me give you the details. Aged 21 years from Tullibardine Distillery, which is just north of the Highland line, the line that divides the Highland region from the Lowland region. It's just along the road from Deanston Distillery. So although it's Highland, it has quite a lot of Lowland characteristics due to its regional geographical location. This has been bottled at 46.9%, and the reason I bought this bottle, malt mates, is because I went into the Cadenhead shop in Edinburgh, had a chat with the very hospitable and friendly guys who work there, and said, guys, recommend me a single malt. And they recommended me a good whisky, because they're there to sell whiskies. Therefore, it's in their interests to recommend one which they know you're going to enjoy, because if they do that, you'll go back to the shop again later and buy some more whisky. That's the way it works. So I'm going to smell this, taste this, tell you all about it, and tell you a little bit about Tullibardine Distillery. And in the second half of this review, 714 extras, I'm going to focus in on fans of distilleries and how that's changed over the years. It's quite an interesting recent phenomenon. Anyway, with this bottle is a card with information and tasting notes. How useful, informative, and all the rest of it. The informative part is that, they say the water comes from the Danny Burn. Big deal. You know, a water source is a water source. Frankly, in my opinion. It doesn't necessarily mean that the distillery is using a particular soft water supply in their bottling plant, but worth mentioning, Tullibardine Distillery have their own bottling plant. That changes things a little bit. The distillery founded in 1949, so it's a fairly young distillery, although if you do visit the distillery, you will see the date 1488 emblazoned on the outside wall, and that's basically a historical, vague, generalised date. Doesn't mean anything particular to that distillery. And we have some tasting notes on the single malt. I would read them out to you, but there's no point because I'm giving you my tasting notes. And the other information, distilled in 1993. Now, not to be confused with a certain vintage 1993 from Tullibardine, which in my opinion is quite a disappointing single malt. I bought a bottle only once. Bottled in 2014, age 21, 46.9% from Refill Hogsheads, Bourbon Hogsheads, furnishing 492 bottles. So it's not actually a single cask, it's a combination of two casks, probably. Maybe three. Information can be useful in these cards, but it can also be distracting. So be aware of that. With time and experience, you know what you're looking for when you read these things, particularly the tasting notes. They're designed sometimes to steer you in your experience rather than guide you. There's a difference. I've not added any water to this yet. Relatively low strength, but it is 21 years old. Perhaps there's been some air got into the casks. Perhaps it's the storage location. Perhaps it's just the provenance. Maybe a leak or two over the years. Goodness knows. Sometimes it's hard to figure these things out. But on the nose, fresh, grassy, grainy, rich grain notes. Some vanilla ties in from the bourbon cask maturation. And slightly aromatic. Little bit of herbal notes and floral notes. Relatively complex. Reminds me of a good Ochentoshan. Taste. Nippy. Quite spicy. Green spices. Herbal. Sage, definitely. Oregano, yes. Parsley, yep. Vanilla. Toffee. Sultana, yep. And then quite prolonged, slight grain sour notes, which, to be honest, initially you're thinking, I'm not too sure about this. With older bottlings of Tullibardine, you may occasionally encounter some slightly off oily notes. Even to this day, we're not sure why that's the case. 1.5 spoons of water, because I've been experimenting with this. So I know exactly how much I want to add. Natural colour, by the way, thought I'd mention that. Unchill filtered too. When you add water, nothing much happens for a few minutes. You really need to give it time. As I've said before, and I'll say it again, because a good piece of advice is well worth repeating. A minute in the glass for a year in the cask. We've already had 20 minutes in the glass, but I've only just added water. And that is going to make a significant difference, because after about 20 minutes, what you will be tasting is virtually unrecognizable from what you first poured, smelled, and tasted. It really will. The nose becomes a little more floral. It settles down. It isn't quite that little hot gingery nip anymore. Taste. The arrival is so much bigger. Full, complex. Sure, there's bitterness in there, a little bit of grain sour, but you're also getting vanilla sweetness. And it's not as if it's kind of an overlapping flavour. It's integrated. The 21 years of maturation are really starting to show. And what happens is this whiskey, seriously, not just a bit, malt mates, really quite a lot of evolving over 10 to 15 minutes in the glass with some water to produce something quite extraordinary. It's a certain flavour profile that I've noticed in lowland single malt whiskies like Bladnach, like St. Maglin, like Little Mill, because I've had quite a few Little Mills over the years, the wonderful, soft, lemony Little Mills, not the nasty ones. And it's really prominent in the development, the lengthening of the development, and the calibre of the finish. The complexity, the subtlety, the understated sophistication, which is suggested rather than imposed. And it's all happening in this bottling. And furthermore, it's not like Laphroaig. It's not Macallan. It's not Talisker. It's not Springbank. So there's no premium pricing on this brand. It is, for its age, a very affordable whiskey. I think from when I bought it, it was about £65 for a 21-year-old single malt. That really is quite affordable. And this is one of the joys of the independent bottlers, is it being able to get access to older, traditionally matured whiskies that have been left alone over the years. They've not been double matured, they've not been extra finished, they've not been recasked and then recasked and fourth cask finishes, five cask finishes, six cask finishes. Where's it going to end, maltmates, with all these cask finishes? It's something that's just old fashioned, it's been overlooked, it's frankly a hidden gem. One more tasting note before the malt mark. The depth of flavour on the arrival is outstanding. Beautiful balance of sweet and sour, hint of salt. The bitterness is so integrated with the sourness. Unusual that. Really a standout feature. The most rich of sultana, mild toffee, butterscotch and grain complex notes. Evolving floral, eau de vie in the development and finishing soft, bitter lemon, a little bit of sour grain in the finish and the softest, but softest of tannins. Just an old school gentleman from yesteryear, which although it was bottled in 2014, I didn't buy for a few years after that. And these bottles tend to spend a long time sitting on shelves because they are so easy to overlook. And they do get overlooked. And I hope this review will highlight this situation to you, because you're malt mates. And you will be looking out for some of these sparkling gems, because they're out there. Malt mark. Oh. I've spilt a bit, but I haven't spilt it all. Thank goodness. And that is a malt mark. Cheers. More time gives you more malt moments. More time in that glass. It just gives you more. What an absolute stunning complex bitterness. Pop back again for Ralfy Review 714 Extras. I will be talking about Tullibardine Distillery, and I will be talking about distillery fans and how important they are. I'm Ralfy. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you shortly.